Hello friends, I welcome you to EBG Paathshala. My name is Dr. Amit Katoch and I am working as assistant professor in University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management of Punjab University. Dear students, I shall be taking lecture on module titled Airport Facility Complex, Airside Building and Landside Facilities. Under the paper titled Aviation Industry, Ticketing and Frontier Formalities. After the module, the students will be able to know about the airport terminal complex and its components, know about the terminal airside facilities, identify the terminal building facilities, and also able to know about the terminal landside facilities. Now, firstly, I would start with a brief introduction. Aviation sector is growing at a very fast rate. Also, there has been increased demand for air travel. And this has reiterated the requirement of efficient airport operations to facilitate the travelers and avoid congestion and delays in the air traffic system. The main airports acting as hub for travel has been affected by congestion at the airports. It further has affected the nature of services at the airport and also at times made it challenging for the airlines and air traffic service providers to manage the travelers, fleets and the staff. The mammoth growth in aviation sector has brought massive changes in the sector, and it is perceived that if only the global fleet of airlines double in two decades, the airport would grow and also its operations. It is projected that the airport congestion would become three times. Hence, proper management of airside and landside operations in an airport is vital and mandatory. Along with it, the give and take of data between airports, airlines, planes and airspace management has also become a critical aspect. Not only global aviation market but Indian market too is growing at a phenomenal pace. India is world's 9th largest civil aviation market, which has grown to the size of about US$16 million and expected to become the 3rd largest aviation market by 2020. Therefore, efficient airport operations are important as they enable smooth and transparent functioning at the airport. In case if there is some flaw in operation in the airport, this may lead to several problems in air travel such as long queues, delay in flights, lost in baggage, rising cost. Hence, airport operations are very critical in the aviation sector. This may result in wastage of time. The time is just like money in case of airport operations, as it may affect the ground handling procedures and also prevent an airline from generating revenues. Air revenues can only be attained if the aircraft is in the air. The global civil aviation sector has shown phenomenal growth, and it has been on account of many factors such as low-cost carriers, larger aircrafts on long-haul flights, increase in air cargo operations, FDI in domestic airlines, modern airports, advancement in information technology, and giving more importance to the regional and local air connectivity. Hence, airports and ground service providers need to utilize the resources in the best possible manner so that the airport copes up with the new arriving trends. Therefore, both staff and equipment should be able to handle the airside and landside operations in a significant way to enhance productivity and limit wastage of resources. For the various operations done in the airports, time and again, SARPs, that is, Standardized and Recommended Practices, have been made a compulsory feature by ICAO at the global level and DGCA at the national level to provide excellent services to the various stakeholders. The Airports Authority of India, AAI, looks after the various airports in India and provides air traffic services, aerodrome services and aeronautical services in accordance to the Chicago Convention. Also, to enhance the safety aspects as stated by ICAO, SMS, that is Supplementary Safety Management Manuals, at each airport are present. The Directorate of Operations of Airports Authority of India executes the role of airside management of Chennai and Trivandrum airports, besides the terminal management of all AAI airports. Now I will discuss about the terminal airside facilities. The integration amongst the terminal building in airport and a site facility plays an important role to accomplish secure and efficient aircraft operations. Therefore, the terminal planner has to be entirely conscious and strict to exact planning regulations and necessities, especially the terminal planner. He has to take into account the various requirements of the airport complex, which comprises airside planning, apron planning, and to see the necessities of the aircraft gates requirement at the airport. The various airside limitations and tasks which should be part of the site planning of the airport terminal complex are the navigable airspace around an airport. Whenever we are considering the runway system and also the airports which employ the aircraft instrument approach and departure procedures, we have to consider the airspace. Maneuvering and separations for an aircraft. When passenger terminal configurations are planned along with aprons, it is important to take into account the maneuvering patterns and aircraft paths which will later help the air terminal complex. Other things which affect the maneuvering of aircraft and operations are number of gates, aircraft type and runway configuration, etc. Number 3, ATCT, that is Air Traffic Control Tower. In order to conduct safe aircraft operations, Air Traffic Control Tower should be able to see all the movement areas on the airfield, that is taxiways, runways and ramps, aircraft parking configurations, etc. Also, it is important to have a clear line of sight from the ramp towers so that air traffic controller is able to see the entry of aircraft into the apron and move in towards luggage gates. In case the ramp tower is not on the airport, then the ATC should be able to see all aircraft ramp areas. Number 4. The access roads to emergency equipment. Immediate response time through emergency equipment access roads should be able to facilitate the entry of largest emergency vehicle without an obstacle. Edge markers to give visual reference to these access roads are also present, which facilitate emergency equipment. Number 5. Airside security. It consists of all parts of the airside of an airport where restrictions for all persons is there. In some airports, this area may be accessible to passengers and staff who have undergone security check. Number 6. Aircraft apron / gate access points. The aircrafts are admitted to terminal gates through taxiway and taxi lane system. Hence, their positioning may be affected by terminal configurations and aircraft configurations. The markings on the apron entrance payment facilitates the pilots to find the direction and position on the apron. Number 7. Aircraft dicing. The aircraft dicing is of two types, that is decentralized and centralized. It prevents accumulation of snow, ice or even frost on the aircraft. A dicing fluid, which is a mixture of glycol and water, is heated and sprayed under pressure by spraying vehicles at the airport prior to departure of aircraft. As the accumulation of ice or snow on the plane's wings and rear tail components may change the shape of the engineered structure and may prevent in the proper lift required for the flight. Number 8. Electronic interference. In order to prevent the terminal facility's interference with the navigational aid present at the ground, computer modeling is used so that terminal building and aircraft parking areas do not interfere. Navigational aids such as localizer, glide slope, DVOR/DME or CVOR, ASR, etc. Now I will discuss about terminal apron planning criteria. The analysis of aircraft gate requirements and the area requirement for other airside components of terminal complex determine the planning criteria for the terminal apron. The various planning aspects include the gates or the parking positions, the aircraft wingtip clearances, aircraft parking guidance systems, gradients for apron or apron gradients, apron service roads, taxiways, passenger walkways, aircraft maneuvering area. Now I will discuss about aircraft gate requirements. Whenever we are planning apron construction or layout in the airport, we need to consider the passenger loading and unloading between the aircraft and the terminal building. Along with apron, the aircraft gates in the airport are also important. What to use and what type of gate greatly depends on the aircraft traffic that is being managed by the terminal complex and also the local airport conditions. Aircraft gates are the remote gates and the contact gates. The remote gates and the contact gates are used synonymously but are different terms. The contact gates lie at short distance or walking distance from the air terminal or are in direct contact with the passenger loading bridge, which is attached to the air terminal. The remote stand or the remote gates are located far away from the terminal and require a transportation mode or bus to transfer the passenger from the terminal to the aircraft. Also, using apron or the loading bridges greatly depend on the level of air service provided by the airport. That's why the regional smaller airports use apron for loading and unloading passengers, while the larger commercial airports uses the passenger loading bridges. Students, now I will discuss about terminal building facilities. The planner's role in creating airport passenger terminals is very challenging. He has to keep in mind the functionality of the airport along with providing good facilities and services of the highest level to the passengers. While constructing terminal complex, the size of the building, the budget, and the time period available for the project are also very important. The planners have to be very innovative and practical to create concession spaces for the travelers, such as retail stores, shopping areas, retail shops, etc., so that enough opportunities are created to increase the concessions revenue. The terminal planner has to work minutely and meet out the needs of the airport clients, airline travelers, airport staff, and other stakeholders. The air terminal should also be able to meet current requirements and future prospects, keeping in mind the customer flows, aviation demand, and other aspects. the terminal planner should be able to deliver the requirements in an air terminal by forming a team with other specialists such as engineers, architects, and professionals from various fields such as security systems, baggage handling systems, people mover system, information technology, and ground transportation planning. Whenever the terminal building facilities are developed, detailed attentions have to be given to all the key stakeholders of the airport. All the important aspects such as airport, master plan, layout plan, land use planning, ground transportation, environmental issues, terminal sites, and other strategies have to be considered minutely. Hence, plan at both micro and macro level has to be formulated. The airport terminal is the main link between the aircraft and the ground access system. It comprises the ground access interface linkage, processing of travelers, baggage formalities, document formalities, cargo handling, airport administration, airport operations, and airport maintenance, etc. So, the planning of airport terminal facilities is a very complex job and it requires a lot of effort. A lot of factors affect it. Some of the factors which need to be considered are size of the airport, volume of air traffic, attributes of the passengers, service area of the airport, type of service provided, that is domestic or international, type of airline service, airline location and its position, aircraft fleet, population profile of the area, geographical area, degree of commercial activity, and obviously what category of passenger it mostly handles. All these factors are important in formulation of mission of the airport, and accordingly a balance has to be maintained between all the elements of the project so that not only the current demands are met, but at the same time there is a scope and room for further development. Therefore, the airport planning process should maintain equilibrium between airside, terminal building, and landside aspects. In order to bring great achievement in terminal planning, design, and construction, it is very important to see or consider factors such as budget, size, schedule, level of service, and quality throughout the project. Convenience of passengers. While constructing the different facilities on the airport, excellent level of service and convenience of travelers as well as airport staff should be taken into account. For example, the airport should provide convenience to the passengers. We know that a large number of factors affect the perception of the passengers with regard to the convenience. Hence, the terminal should have good facilities and ambience. Walking distance in the terminal should be kept short and easy, and moreover, less time should be associated with the moving on the terminal. Number two, flexibility in terminal buildings. The structures of airport terminal are susceptible to outmoddedness. Though architects try a lot to give lastingness or permanence to the airport terminal, but they suffer from vulnerability owing to rapid changes in technology, operations, business parameters, new regulatory requirements, pattern of airline demand, and the airline industry. So it is very difficult to get forward in all the attributes related to an airport terminal. But if some room or flexibility is given to the structure so that some changes can be made to the old structure and the life of the structure can be extended depending on the present demand. Number three, security. Security is an important aspect involved in terminal planning as it protects the individuals present on the air terminal, that is travelers and the airport staff. As in some large and busy airports, high concentrations of populace are easy targets of terror. enhanced security is accomplished not only through the airport layout and design of the terminal complements with the airport security plan. All the areas such as parking, taxiways, roadways, etc. should be complemented with the security plan. Apart from the plan of security, the equipments for security such as screening machines, portable checking machines for individual customers or visitors should be of excellent category so that first rate level of security is provided at the airports. Terminal signage and path finding. The most important purpose of any airport terminal complex is to permit efficient movement of users on the terminal and movement of vehicles in the roadways or other transportation ways used in and outside the airport. When planning for a terminal complex, primary goal is to make crisscrossing the facilities as untaught as far as possible for each user. This is known as intuitive way finding. Number 5. Accessibility of airport. Accessibility is an important aspect in airport terminal planning. Hence, there should be no discrimination whether normal individuals or persons with disabilities, and hence every individual should be able to access the various facilities present on the airport terminal. While designing the airport terminal, the designing of the airport is done in such a way that which facilitates the persons with disabilities such as visually impaired, deaf, mobility impaired, etc. Number 6. Maintenance. Whenever the airport terminal is designed, its architectural design is made in such a way that is easy to maintain later on. Hence, the structure should be aligned with the maintenance strategy so that it is easy to clean and maintain the building later on. In every airport, there are a large number of stakeholders who work in various capacities at various places present in the airport. Hence, it is important to assess their needs and demands and to make spaces to fulfill their needs and simply their maintenance operations. Number 7. Concept development of terminal. The development of passenger terminal facilities at the airport involves great thinking and design process which combines quantitative facility requirements with comprehensive knowledge of the operations, which should be performed on the airside, landside and terminal buildings of the airport. After the planner has got a thorough understanding about the mission, concept and need of the main stakeholders, he designs the structure accordingly. The terminal complex should have single centralized processing facility or multiple processing facilities. It all depends on the demand of the passengers, level of aircraft activity, level of service required, whether the airport is normal or a greenfield site, etc. The centralized terminal facilities consist of a single consolidated terminal which maximizes passenger processing capacity and eliminates unnecessary facility duplication. In case of decentralized terminal facilities, there are multiple unit terminals which provide various facilities such as building, services, restrooms, vertical circulation and other structures independently. The decentralized terminal complexes are made in order to fulfill the needs such as different type of airline services on the basis of domestic or international operation, or maybe due to large operations where various terminals may cater to different parts of the world. The air terminal may have different terminal facilities requirements which are very necessary for its operation. There may be many facilities and amenities which at present on the airport, which may vary due to the schedule of airlines, degree of business and leisure travel, short or long haul flights, degree of passenger activity, domestic or international passenger. The various terminal facilities or counters present on the airport are such as check-in facilities, airport information centers, Wi-Fi facility and telecommunication services, phone or computer recharge facilities in the stations, wheelchair provision or storage for disabled persons, electric passenger carts, passenger luggage trolleys, baggage handling systems, alternative electrical power arrangements for security, communications, operations and emergency systems, security lighting system both inside and outside of the airport. Now I will discuss about terminal landside facilities. The operation at the terminal landside facility are guided by the presence of number of passenger arrivals and departures and the cargo activity if present on the terminal. The traffic operations of the landside facilities apart from the peaking characteristics depend on a number of things such as the vehicle speed on the airport roadways is very slow than the peripheral roadways. Different types of vehicles transfers roadways on the airport. Complex routings present on the airport and multiple ways to navigate the roadway system. The roadway layout in the airport may vary from airport to airport. There are large number of merge or diverge points and hence drivers have to take short decisions at very short distances. In many cases, the drivers do occasionally visit the facility, are confused, so they move at slow speeds. The ground access systems inside the airports are complex, interrelated facilities and hence require detailed planning, analysis and evaluation of the current facilities present at the airport. The intermodal connections present on the airport are of two types. The first type comprises the local or regional rail or bus system and the second one comprises the rail or bus system present on the airport. In some cases, mass transit systems also help in transportation inside the terminal and provide access to the airport, terminal and concession employees. A large number of airport roadway systems are present on the airport, such as exit roadways, terminal approach roads, terminal curb front, recirculation roads, service roads, etc. Also, the terminal curb front of an airport is a highly complex operating area which allows the vehicles to load and unload passengers and luggage and then merge away to the main traffic road. This curb front area of the terminal landside area of the airport can be divided into two types, that is pedestrian facilities and vehicle facilities. Parking facilities are also present on the landside area of the airport and it provides facilities to a number of users such as travelers, employees, tenants and rental cars. Broadly, there are five types of parking facilities which depend upon the demand for parking. Terminal parking. Terminal parking is the close-in parking facility and the most convenient parking facility for the passengers. It provides both short-term and long-term parking facility. Remote parking facilities. They remain at distance from the airport facility and generally provides parking facility for long-term. They also require on-airport transit capabilities to carry passengers from parking to terminal and vice versa. The remote parking charges are less than the terminal parking. Off-airport parking facilities are same as the remote parking facilities but are present outside the airport property and are generally handled by private operators. Valid parking facilities. They are provided at large number of airports for the departing passengers who leave their vehicles parked at the curb front all in terminal parking plots, cell phone lots. They are very useful in reducing traffic congestions as they are present along the entrance road to the terminal, where he she can wait for a call from the passenger and come as soon as he calls him or her. Now I would summarize the whole module. The aviation sector is growing at a very fast rate, and so is the structure of the airport terminal complex. But broadly, the airport terminal complex comprises three components, that is terminal airside facilities, the terminal building facilities, and the terminal landside facilities. But the various facilities present throughout the airport depends on a number of factors, such as the flow of passengers, the airline traffic, level of service, etc., which are present in the airport. The terminal airside facilities comprises a number of facilities and procedures such as the runway, air traffic control tower, access roads to emergency equipment, aircraft apron, gate access points, apron service roads, taxiways, passenger walkways, and the airport maneuvering area. The terminal building facilities is the main link between the aircraft and the ground access system. It comprises the ground access interface linkage, processing of travelers, baggage formalities, document formalities, cargo handling, airport administration, airport operations, and airport maintenance, etc. The planning of airport terminal facilities is a very complex job, and a lot of factors affect it. The operations at the terminal landside facility are guided by the presence of number of passenger arrivals and departures and the cargo activity if present on the terminal, and comprises the airport roadway systems such as exit roadways, terminal approach roads, terminal curb front, recirculation roads, service roads, etc., and parking facility such as terminal parking, remote parking, off-airport parking facilities, valid parking facilities, cell phone lots, etc. At the end of the module, I would like to say is that all the three components of airport complex, that is landside facilities, airside facilities, and terminal building facilities, are vital for air operations, but it's important to keep a balance between them. Thank you and have a nice day.